Hello friends, I'm Dr. Pooja Kapoor, Consultant Pediatric Neurologist, Paras Hospital, Gurgaon, Director and Co-Founder, Continua Kids. So today, we're going to have a word on role of MMR vaccine or measles, mumps, rubella vaccine in autism spectrum disorder. So the study goes back to 1998 when a UK-based gastroenterologist, Dr. Andrew Wakefield, published his data based on 12 children who were given vaccine, MMR vaccine, and after that they developed features of autism spectrum disorder. So he said that all children who were given MMR vaccine, whom he studied, were normal before, and after the vaccine they developed, out of 12 children, 8 developed the symptomatology of something like autism spectrum disorder. And he studied the gut biopsy of these children and said that MMR vaccines, specifically the virus, measles virus, caused inflammation of the gut, causing the gut to become more leaky and absorbent, and the toxic substances in the gut, which were not to be absorbed by the normal gut, were absorbed, and these toxic substances in return cause what you call as autism-like symptoms because they affected the brain of these children. This was his hypothesis, although there was no causal relationship was put in the Lancet journal. But after, just after this was published, a lot of media hue and cry came over, and everybody was scared of the MMR vaccine. So this was again, this all of his data was under scrutiny, and later by 2010 this study was termed as fraudulent, and all the journal the data was retracted. They found out that it was a falsified data which he had put in. He said all the children who were studied, of the 12 children, were normal before, but no, out of them a few of them already had certain delays and were not absolutely normal. Secondly, he said that 8 children out of 12 developed symptomatology mimicking the autism spectrum disorder, whereas not more than 2 children had certain features associated. So there was a lot of misfalsified data which was put in, and above all it was found that Dr. Wakefield has a lot of financial implication from these studies. He already had the patent for a single antigen vaccine which he had put in before the publication of his data, and as he had put in his data that if he will give only a single antigen based vaccine, that means not a combined MMR but a single MMR, then that would not cause the autism like symptoms, and he had already put a patent before the publication of his study. Also he had certain financial gain from the attorneys against the who were filing case against the vaccine manufacturers. So looking up all these things, the study was turned fraudulent, and the data was it was retracted from the book. And because this was a big hue and cry by the media, so a lot and lot all over the world, the association of measles, mumps vaccine, measles, mumps, rubella vaccine and autism was studied. And in none of the study later, there was any close relationship which was found. And so this was proven that there was no association of measles, mumps, rubella vaccine and autism spectrum disorder. Similarly, just as when these things were going on, the things were studied, there was another thing which came up into the picture, and that was thimerosal. It is basically a preservative which is there in all the vaccines, in most of the vaccines, as a preservative. All those multivial vaccine, it is a bactericidal agent which just kills the bacteria, which prevents the bacteria from multiplying once the vial is of the vaccine is open. And it contains mercury. So a new hypothesis was put in and said that there's a high content of mercury in these vaccines based on thimerosal, and because of this the poisoning of the brain occurs, and that also can give rise to symptomatology of autism spectrum disorder. But after again a lot of studies, this was not proven in any of the studies. Still the government of US stopped using thimerosal after 2001. And as we can see that even after stopping thimerosal in the vaccines after 2001, we are still getting a high rate of incidence of autism spectrum disorder in children. The incidence is, the prevalence is increasing steadily till this date also. So this again proved that thimerosal or the heavy metal poisoning or mercury was not responsible for causing anything related to autism spectrum disorder. One thing, take home message is that this is definitely proven that if we don't give measles vaccine to our children, then there's a disease called it SSPE, that is subsclerosing panencephalitis. In this, the measles virus just goes in. Once you get measles during your early childhood period, the virus goes in the brain and remains latent. And once your immunity goes down, he just pulls up and causes this SSPE disease, in which you lose your vision, your movement, your walking, your talking, your intellect, your cognition, your vision, and you just have multitude, hundreds and thousands of seizures per day. And this is caused by measles. And the preventable way is to give measles vaccine to our children. We see a lot of children who get SSP once you are not vaccinated, or all those who get measles disease in the early years of life. So it's a take-home message. Kindly vaccinate your children as according to your pediatrician and make them safer from all these vaccine preventable diseases. So we'll keep you updated, whatever research and knowledge we have about autism spectrum disorder. Keep watching for the further videos. Thank you for patient hearing. Thank you so much.